Hi guys, I'm Sonal and welcome to my channel. Today I'm making a chocolate cake. It was overdue. I made my lemon pound cake and after that it's been a while since I've made a proper baked chocolate cake, which is what I'm going to share with you today. So let's go ahead and see how I make this recipe. Here I'm preparing the pan. So I've taken some parchment paper and sized it according to the size of the pan. And I'm folding it into a cone. So you fold it in quarters and then keep folding it till you get that shape. I'm trying to put the pointed end at the center of the pan and get an idea of how big the pan is. And then I'm just chopping off the end. I put butter on the pan as well as on top of the parchment paper. And now our pan is ready. Here I'm using some homemade almond flour. So I've soaked the almonds, toasted and then made flour out of it. I would not advise you to do that because it's very difficult to get a fine grind. So we have 2 cups of almond flour here, 5 teaspoons of coconut flour, 1 teaspoon of baking powder and 1 teaspoon of baking soda, 1/2 teaspoon of instant coffee and 1/4 cup of dark cocoa powder. And I have 6 eggs here to which I'm adding 1 teaspoon of vanilla essence and mixing all that really well. Once that is done, I'm adding about 3/4 cup of erythritol. So this is 1/2 cup and I'm gonna add 1/4 cup more. That's a 1/4 cup. To this, I'm adding 1 cup of melted butter. And you wanna mix everything really well. There you go, some of the butter is not really melted, but it still works. To this, I'm adding 1/2 cup of apple cider vinegar. Don't worry, it's not going to taste vinegary or sour. This is stevia drops. I'm adding about 12 stevia drops. Make the whole mixture ready for the cake and then give it a taste according to your liking of sweetness. And then probably add a little more stevia if you need that. So I'm mixing the dry mixture now. And to this I'm adding our wet mixture and I'm going to give it a nice mix. And there you go. So we are going to put it in our prepared cake pan and put it in the oven at 180 degrees centigrade or 350 degrees Fahrenheit for about 1 hour. So anywhere from 55 minutes to 1 hour to a little longer depending upon your oven. So in the meanwhile, we're going to make the frosting. This is 1 cup of butter and 1 cup of cream cheese to which we are adding 1/4 cup of erythritol, 15 drops of stevia, 1/4 cup of cocoa powder. I like the blend of stevia and erythritol because erythritol kind of gives it the sugary taste and the stevia actually makes it sweet. And we're going to put our icing in the refrigerator for 1/2 hour. So here our cake is ready. I'm running a knife around it and we are going to get it out. I like using a springform pan because it's easier to get the cake out. I left the cake a little longer than I should have. So it's a little drier than I would have liked, but it still works. It was delicious. I'm cutting some of the edges. I've inverted the cake and I've put it on a lazy Susan, which helps in icing the cake. But if you don't have it, you can put it in a plate. And to this, I'm going to add some of the sugar-free raspberry syrup that I have. You can add any syrup of your liking. It just makes the cake a little more moist. And this is our icing. And I'm going to show you a couple of ways to ice it. This is like drawing a spiral. So you just take your spatula from the center to outside while you're rotating the cake with the other hand. And this other style is just making peaks on the cake, which looks really homemade. Does give it a nice rustic look. So I'm going to keep that look. And now I'm icing the sides. And our cake is ready. How simple is that? If you want, you can put some whipped cream on top. And look at that. I'm going to cut a slice and show it to you. It looks so decadent, right? And it tasted just as good. The cake was absolutely delicious. I made pieces of it and I've put them in the freezer now to be eaten over a period of time. You get quite a few slices out of it. I have made about 10 slices. Each of this slice is a little more than what I like to eat after I've eaten my food. A little goes a long way. Please try this recipe and let me know how it turned out for you. If you like the recipe, please click the like button, subscribe to my channel, and thanks for watching. I also have a Marathi channel. You can subscribe to that. I'm leaving a link to that in the description section. If you'd like to watch my other cake recipes, there will be a link on the screen for that and also links in the description section. Don't forget to check out the macros and the ingredients in the description section again.